Today we are going to start with the discussion of the poem Rain on the Roof. So in order to have a proper connection with the poem, let us start the explanation of the poem. So you must remember, when the humid showers hover, what does the humid hover? Humid showers represent, yes, sad and sorrow, but it is also metaphorically used for the clouds. Okay, over all the starry spheres. What does starry sphere signify? Sky, the stars, as well as the moon in the sky. And the melancholy darkness, melancholy, again it is metaphor, darkness. Okay, the sadness that covers the sky as well as nature gently weeps in rainy tears. It gently weeps in rainy tears means that the sorrow which was covering the sky, now it gently comes down. When it comes down, when the shower of rain falls, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed. And it will really be a blissful moment to press your head against the pillow in the cottage and to listen this sound. And lie listening to the patter. Patter is what? This is onomatopoeia. Okay, pitter patter sound. It means this sound is particularly related to that of rain. And lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. And it will really be a blissful moment to listen to the pitter patter sound of the rain that is falling on the roof of the cottage. So every tinkle on the shingles, tinkle means drop and shingles means tiled roof. Okay, every drop that falls onto the roof has an echo in the heart. What it does, it produces an echo in the heart, sound in the heart, and a thousand dreamy fancies means old memories. This is an example of transferred epithet. Okay, and into busy being start is an example of alliteration. Moreover, it is also an example of transferred epithet. Why transferred epithet? Because busy being refers to the busy mind, okay, not the human being. Okay, into busy being start and a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof. So this is what it means, recollections, old memories. Can they be able to formulate a woof of sort of cloth or fabric? No. It means this is an example of personification here. What is this example? This is an example of personification used here. And as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. So when does this happen? When I listen to the pitter patter of the rain, that is to the soft falling rain shower onto the roof or onto the roof of the cottage. And the poet is saying that it is really a blissful moment to listen to the pitter patter sound of the soft falling shower at that time. And now in memory comes my mother. So in that, at that time, what happens? That in his memory, who comes? His mother. His mother comes in his memory as she used in years agone. Years agone, what does this signify? It signifies that the mother is no longer more. Okay, she is dead. She used to come when she was alive and to regard the darling dreamers. Darling dreamers, who are they? Siblings, brothers and sisters, darling dreamers, again an example of alliteration as well as transferred epithet. Okay, means before she left them before she left them till the dawn. When they left them, when? Till the dawn. As I list to the this refrain, list means as I listen to this refrain. Refrain means the lines which are used again and again in the poem, but they enclose the main idea or the main theme of the poem. When this happens, he said, when it is which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. When this happens, when this soft falling shower, it falls onto the roof of the cottage, right? So this is the poem. And now let us discuss the question answers of the poem. So come up to the question answers, which are given at the back of this poem. So here are the question answers. You can very well see it.
Yes.
What do the following phrases mean to you? Discuss in class. Humid showers, humid shadows. Dark and moisture laden. Humid means moisture laden, filled with moisture. The clouds which are filled with moisture. Okay, right. Then starry spheres. Yes, including stars as well as moon and other celestial bodies which are shining in nature. What a bliss. What a bliss. Yes. Your name? Panika. Huh. Sudden emotion of joy. And yes, sudden emotion of joy. Right. A thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. So what it means, that number of fancies they come into mind when he is listening to this soft falling shower, when he is listening to this pitter patter of the rain. So, and a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof. Thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof. Yes, Dia.
Small and old memories woke into a large enjoyable moment.
The poet is saying that many old memories, enjoyable moments, they come into his mind, and this, these moments, they ultimately formulate an old incident which has already happened in his life. So, what does the poet like to do when it rains? Yes, what does the poet like to do when it rains?
When it rains, the poet wants to lie snugly in the cottage with a soft pillow under his head. He wants to enjoy the rhythmic soft music of the raindrops falling on the
roof. Okay, he is enjoying the soft falling rain on the roof, and he wanted to press his pillow, press his head against the pillow, and to enjoy the pitter patter sound and to enjoy the blissful moment which he feels at that very time when he is pressing his head against the pillow. Next, what is the single major memory that comes to the poet, and what are the darling dreamers he refers to? What is the single major memory? Yes. Very good. Yes, excellent. So what is the single major memory that comes to the poet's mind? The single major memory that comes to the poet's mind is of his mother. Okay, that comes to his mind, and also along with mother, he is also remembering his siblings, darling dreamers. Okay, what does this refer to? It refers to his siblings or brothers and sisters. And her mother and his mother used to come into the room and provide a caressing look, means loving look, onto them when they were sleeping into their beds. Next. Is the poet now a child, or is his mother still alive? Yes. What do you say? Any other child? Put your hands down. Yes, Vatsal. Do you think the poet is still a child? No. What does he now? He has grown up now. He is no longer a child. Okay. And is his mother still alive? No. How we come to know? Sit down, please. Because the poet has said in the years agone. Agone means passed by. Means when she was alive. Next, when you were a young child, did your mother tuck you in as the poets did? Yes, this is the common phenomena. Okay, mother is the figure who loves her children a lot, who used to take care of her children, and whatever the circumstances are, the mother is always a great helping hand as well as supporter of the children. This also happens with us, right? So, do you like rain, and what do you do when it rains steadily or heavily as described in the poem? Yes. Okay, right. So next question is again your own creativity, but before that, let us discuss some extra questions. Write down first question: how does the poet describe the moment just before it starts raining? Describe the moment just before it starts raining. So how he describes the moment just before it starts raining. Yes, that the sky is covered with dark clouds which are filled with moisture, and it seems that the entire nature it is covered with sadness. And the soft falling shower, when it falls down, it pours down, it sheds its water down. This veil means covering, okay, of the darkness or of the sadness, it is ultimately removed from the face of the earth, right? Next question is, what thoughts flash through the poet's mind when it rains? What thoughts flash through the poet's mind when it rains, yes. What are the thoughts that flash through the poet's mind when it rains? Yes. Yes, how she used to come and to provide a caressing as well as loving look to her children. Moreover, during while he is enjoying the rain, number of old memories, okay, they also come into his mind, that also take his mind onto a journey of his some other old incidents that happened in his memory lane. Or you can say his mind got busy into number of memories of old time and has taken the poet down the memory lane of his past. Okay, down the memory lane of his past. Next is, how does the poet find it a bliss to feel when it rains? How does the poet find it a bliss when it rains? How does the poet find it a bliss when it rains? Good. Right. And while pressing his head against the pillow, number of old memories come into his mind, making his mind busy, and takes the poet down his memory lane. And he is also remembering his mother, who has been dead some years ago. And moreover, what kind of look her mother used to provide when he is taking rest or when he is asleep early in the dawn along with his siblings. Yes, to revive his past, you can say also that. Okay, right. So next question is, when does the poet remember his mother, and how does he do so? When does the poet remember his mother and how does he do so? How does he remember his mother? When he is enjoying the soft falling shower onto the shingles. Okay, then what happens? Yes, he listens to the pitter-patter of the rain. And at that moment, his mind has gone down his memory lane and has brought the thoughts of his mother, which is no more alive. He is remembering his mother, who used to come early in the morning before going for the work, and she used to provide a caressing as well as loving look towards her children. Okay, so it means that the poet remembers his mother a lot when this kind of soft falling shower, it falls onto the roof of the top. Next question, please. What does the poet dream of when he listens to the patter of the rain? Again, of the same time. Same type. What does the poet dream of when he listens to the patter of the rain? Yes. What does he do when he listens to the... Yes, of course. He... So almost the same answer, right? Next is, what type of feeling does the rain falling on the roof evoke? What kind of feeling does the rain falling evoke? What kind of feeling is evoked? Feeling of happiness, feeling of old memories, okay? Makes his mind busy. He used to listen to the, he used to remember the old memories which have been, which have, or the incidents which have happened in his life. This produced a feeling of ultimate bliss. Okay, he is feeling blissful. He is feeling enjoyable. He is feeling, you can say, contented. He is feeling satisfied. Okay, because otherwise, because of being too much busy in his daily work, the poet is not able to remember his mother. But at this time, when this soft falling shower, it is falling onto the rain, what he is doing? He is remembering his mother a lot. Okay. Now, in Rain on the Roof, the poet brings out how rain soothes everyone by its phenomena and describe how this value has been brought out by the poet. So how the rain, you can say, it soothes the human being. So let me explain. First of all, take it in context to that of nature. Okay. So when the soft falling shower, it falls onto the roof of the cottage, at that moment before it rains, it seems that the entire sky, it is covered with a sort of darkness. It is filled with moisture laden clouds. Okay, but ultimately when this soft falling shower, it pours down onto the surface of the earth, then what happens? It seems that this darkness, it has been erased, it has been removed from the face of the earth. Everyone is feeling quite satisfied, quite soothed, as well as relaxed when the soft falling shower, it falls onto the earth. Okay. And moreover, the poet also feels it a blissful moment. How the poet feels it a blissful moment? Because for the poet, he thought that it is really a moment of ultimate joy. Okay. When he is recollecting some old memories of his past. Okay, he is recollecting many old memories of his past when he is remembering some, you can say, special incidents of his life, which otherwise he is not able to recollect. Okay, so his mind got busy into those kind of old memories, And ultimately what happens that he is enjoying that blissful moment. Okay, he is enjoying that blissful moment. And because of this, he is also remembering his mother who was alive at one time, but who's no longer alive in his life. He used to remember the caressing, the loving, as well as the touching look of the mother who used to come into his room and provide a caressing look towards all the siblings, as well as the poet giving him a special touch of love and affection of the mother. The poet at that time, he is enjoying that blissful moment, which is otherwise not possible in his life. So this kind of, you can say, soothness, this kind of enjoyment is ultimately brought about by rain only. So rain has the quality to soothe our senses, not physically also, by eroding away all the heat that has been produced onto the earth, and but ultimately providing it softened as well as moisture touch. But ultimately it is also soothing our memories, our thoughts and our feelings too, and providing a refreshing, as it refreshes nature, as it rejuvenates nature, in the same manner it is rejuvenating ourselves and making us, yes, it refreshes our mind and making us fresh for the next moment in life, right? So that's all for rain on the roof. If anybody has any problem, you can ask me. It's clear? First row, second row, third row, fourth row, everyone. Online students, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Fourth and fifth line of second paragraph. What a bliss. Yes, and 1,000 dreamy fancies, right? This, speak the line. Yes, 1,000 recollections, that many old memories come into his mind. Recollection means old incidents. And weave their air threads into woof. Air threads, they will join. Woof means to formulate a fabric. But here it is personification. These recollections, some old memories, they are formulating a particular incident of his life. Okay, so this is the meaning. Any other doubt? That's it. And are you all clear with that of, you can say, literary devices, poetic devices used here? Okay, that's all, right? So now let me have a short discussion about the notebooks. How many of you have not submitted the notebook?